Turn to 2 Timothy chapter 3 and Ezekiel chapter 37, all right? 2 Timothy chapter 3, open your Bibles to that verse, and then put a marker at Ezekiel 37. It's probably the only two passages that we'll turn to today, although we'll look at more. Can I ask you something? We're in this series called The Holy Bible Beyond Words. Are you enjoying this series? You know, one of the reasons that I'm so proud of you is because it seems like when the Holy Spirit speaks something to us as a congregation, we all engage in it. We all begin going that way. And God is speaking to all of us right now about refreshing and renewing our love for His Word. And I'm just so proud of you for following me in that, all right? We've had two messages so far. We talked about the bread of heaven, that the Word of God is bread that nourishes us. We've talked about the water of life, that it is our water that refreshes us. And this week, we're going to talk about the breath of God. The breath of God. And I'm going to show you that Scripture literally is God's breath. It is breathed by God. And when we read the Word, meditate on the Word, memorize the Word, we are breathing in the very breath of God. Now, take these three analogies, these three symbols, bread, water, and breath. And let me ask you something. How long can you go without bread? How long can you go without food if you had water? Now, most people say 40 to 80 days, somewhere in that range. So you could go maybe a month or two, maybe up to three. But you couldn't sustain that. You have to have bread. You have to have food. How long could you go without water? Well, most say 4 to 12 days. Maybe under some circumstances, physical fitness, maybe you could go longer, but you couldn't go months. You could go days. How long could you go without air? Minutes? I grew up with a swimming pool, and I started scuba diving when I was very young, started love water. Most of you know we have a boat, and I started water skiing when I was six, and so I've done a lot of water things, and used to just, out in the middle of the lake, I just used to say, can I swim to the shore, you know? And I don't know if it was just that we didn't have a lot of safety consciousness back then when I was growing up, or my parents didn't really care. I don't know, but, you know, I know they did. But my dad would say, yeah, so, you know, I just jump out of the boat in the middle of the lake and swim the shore. And so I did a lot of swimming growing up and used to hold my breath. And I used to try to see, they said Navy SEALs could hold their breath for about 4 minutes, which is about the longest that a person do it. The record, I think, is 5 to 6 minutes. Pretty incredible. But I got to a place where I could hold my breath for 3 minutes. And I can't do that anymore. I don't know if you've been to like Colorado or somewhere and maybe where the air is thinner and, you know, you climb stairs or go to the bathroom and you get out of breath. Is it possible, since the Scripture is the breath of God, that some of us live in an oxygen, spiritual oxygen depleted atmosphere? And that it just takes just a little bit of stress to get us out of breath. Because this is the breath of God. And I'm going to show it to you, all right? 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16. Remember John 3:16? You might be able to remember this. It's in 2 Timothy, but it's chapter 3, verse 16. 2 Timothy 3, verse 16. All Scripture, not part of it, some of it, but all of it. All Scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable, remember the word inspiration, is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness or right standing with God. All Scripture is given by inspiration of God. Now let me tell you what the Greek word there for inspiration is. It is theopneustos. Theo coming from the word God, theos. Neustos means breathed. Matter of fact, here it is in another version, in the NIV version. All Scripture is God-breathed. That is the literal translation of the word, theonoustos. God-breathed. Noustos, another Greek word that is the root word is pneuma. Many of you have heard that. It means air, such as if you had pneumonia. It means that you have a problem with your breathing, your breath. Pneumatic, if you have a power tool that's pneumatic, it runs on air. So that's where we get this. So this word, all Scripture, is given by inspiration of God. Let me say it another way. All Scripture is breathed by God. This book is the very breath of God. I want you to think about that. Now turn to Ezekiel chapter 37, and we're going to develop this idea a little bit more, this truth. Ezekiel chapter 37, verse 1. Ezekiel 37, verse 1. The hand of the Lord came upon me and brought me out in the Spirit of the Lord and set me down in the midst of the valley, and it was full of bones. Bones. Then he caused me to pass by them all around, and behold, there were very many in the open valley, and indeed they were very dry, no water. And he said to me, Son of man, can these bones live? So I answered, O Lord God, you know, you're the only one that knows that. Again he said to me, now watch this, prophesy or speak to these bones and say to them, O dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Now we're talking about the words of God or breath. Hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord God to these bones, surely I will cause breath to enter into you, and you shall live. I will put sinews on you and bring flesh upon you, cover you with skin and put breath in you, and you shall live. Then you shall know that I am the Lord. So I prophesied, so I spoke as I was commanded. And as I prophesied, there was a noise and suddenly a rattling, and the bones came together, bone to bone. Indeed, as I looked, the sinews and the flesh came upon them, and the skin covered them over, but there was no breath in them. I wonder how many people feel that way. Feel like they're alive, but no breath in them. And he said to me, prophesy to the breath, prophesy, son of man. Many people thought he said prophesy to the wind, but it's the breath. And say to the breath, thus says the Lord God, come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe on these slain that they may live. So I prophesied as he commanded me, and breath came into them, and they lived and stood upon their feet, an exceedingly great army. The breath of God in this passage transforms a valley of dry bones into an exceedingly great army, and they're alive. So I want to show you four things that the breath of God gives today. And remember, all Scripture is God-breathed.